Hi, YouTube family. You guys asked, I said I would, and so here we are today. I'm going to be reviewing all of the Ordinary products that I have. Yes, this is a megaton, but I did want to share these with you. I also have a couple of different little skincare products in here from their sister companies. So we're going to get right into it. If you're new to my channel, I would love for you to subscribe by clicking the button below. Don't forget to hit the bell icon, and please give this video a thumbs up if at any time during the video you are enjoying it. I do appreciate that. Okay, we're going to start from where you start with your face, and we're going to go clear through it. And as I show you these things, I'm going to tell you whether I put them into the nighttime routine or whether I put them into the AM routine. I'm going to make sure I throw that up on the camera. So this might be a little bit more in depth, a little bit more along the lines of being an extensive review of what I do. So please bear with me. I hope it holds your attention the whole time. We're going to start with their squalane cleanser that I got. I love this stuff, you guys. It is made with squalane oil. It does come out very emollient. It also almost comes out like a lotion. A little bit goes a long ways, but what they tell you to do is put it in between your fingertips, and what happens is it turns into an oil. And that oil can take off any eye makeup. It can take off any regular makeup. And what it does, squalane is so hydrating and so yummy that it will leave your skin very, very hydrated. And I find that I have to go in with a double cleanse because I am going to be doing my serums. So if you need a hydrating cleanser, that's great. But I do know that I don't want there to be oil on my face left over after I'm cleansing at night, because I really want my serums to sink in. And that's more important to me than having my skin hydrated at that point. So that's kind of a pro and a con of that. If you wanted to use it in the morning, you wouldn't have to do anything else, because really it leaves your skin that hydrated. I am not kidding. And the squalane oil doesn't like make your skin super oily after it works in a little bit. And especially after you wipe it away with a cloth, a warm wash rag, I really like it. Okay, the second step, this is at night. Nighttime, I go in with the glycolic acid 7% solution. I love this stuff, you guys. This is a mild exfoliant. It's not a super high exfoliant. So if you do have skin that is sensitive, this one you can use. It can be that you might be too sensitive to use every night. So give it a little test. You know, if on the second night you've used it and you feel like your skin is a little bit more on the owie side, or whatever you get, you know, whether you have redness or whatever with it, then you might want to skip to every other night. I also use the lactic acid from them. This is the 10% lactic acid, and I use this on alternate nights. So I won't do this two together because the acids are too much. If you did them together, you would get too strong of an exfoliant. If you have really tough skin, you feel like your skin is really tough and it's not sensitive at all, then you might feel like you can try them in conjunction with each other. There's nothing wrong with that. You are more than welcome to try those. But if you're noticing any irritation whatsoever, make sure you do them on alternate nights and maybe skip a night in between if you have very, very sensitive skin. But they're excellent, excellent exfoliants that just happen gently instead of all at once. Now, one exfoliant that does happen all at once is the AHA BHA peeling solution. I'm using up another chemical exfoliant at the moment, so I don't have that one with me right now. And in the bottle, it's very red, so you guys know that is perfectly normal. It looks like it's almost beet juice. It's so red. You put that on and you leave it on for no more than 10 minutes, and then you wipe it away and you make sure all the acid is neutralized with a lot of lukewarm water, or, you know, cool water, whatever you choose. And I love that stuff because afterwards my skin feels so smooth and so soft. I do want to mention one ingredient that goes into the Ordinary's acids. These are the ones that I just showed you, and this ingredient is in all three of them. And I'm just going to read this right out of the website. It says this formula contains a studied Tasmanian pepperberry derivative to help reduce irritation associated with acid use. They also have a cross polymer, which means different form of hyaluronic acid, to help soothe the skin. The pepperberry helps smooth the skin, but this is even further. And vitamin B5 to assist healing, and then black carrot as an antioxidant. Also in the glycolic acid along with the pepperberry, there is ginseng root and aloe vera for radiance and soothing benefits in that one. And then the lactic acid, it just has the pepperberry in it for the soothing soothing effects. It doesn't have any of those others in it. If you're going to do that peel, the BHA, the AHA peel that comes with the red in the bottle, that is a once a week thing that I would do on clean, dry skin. You don't want any oils, so the squalane cleanser would not be good to do that. You can do it in the AM or the PM. And one of the things that it did say about these is make sure that you're, because your skin is a little bit hypersensitive, that you're make sure you're wearing your sunscreen in the morning. And that is one thing that you absolutely want to do every day anyway, but you want to pay better attention to it on the days when your skin feels extra sensitive from some of these chemical exfoliants, because you might be overdoing it a little bit and it might be a little bit more photosensitive. Okay, we're going to move on to serums. Niacinamide is really good for helping with blemishes, reduce the appearance of those, and it's also good for helping to unclog your pores. Really, really excellent to help both of those things. If you have large pores and you find that you have a lot of congestion there, you might want to be using that one. I do use that one myself. Alpha Arbutin. This one is help to reduce the spots or the dark spots that you might have from age spots, sunspots, anything like that that you have going on. And I have the Argireline, which is said to be the Botox in a bottle. I don't know if I am as sold on the Argireline as I have heard so many people be, because I've used two bottles of it and I really try hard to just stick where my dynamic folds and wrinkles are, which is on my lips, over my forehead, crow's feet, underneath the eyes, and then across the neck. And I don't really know that I have noticed that much difference. I'm on, like I said, I'm on my second or third bottle. And I'm not sure I'm going to be repurchasing that one because it just doesn't work that great for me. Now, there are some people that just say, oh my goodness, this is so wonderful, and it works really good for them. So if you want to try it out, it's really not that expensive. So go ahead and try that one out. And then the Buffet, it is really good for, because it has peptides in it. It has multi-peptides in it. Plus it has hyaluronic acid. Plus it has a few other things in it that are just, that's why it's called the Buffet, because it takes a bunch of other really good skincare ingredients and it combines it. And then I also do have the Copper Buffet, the Buffet with Copper Peptides. This has an extra boost of copper peptides that are supposed to be just a little bit extra guns, you know what I mean? I have used two of these. This is my third one. I wanted to give this a really good, you know, go as far as whether or not I wanted to choose the Buffet or whether I wanted to choose this one. This one is quite a bit more expensive. I will throw both of those up on the screen right now so you can see how much those are. But personally, I haven't noticed that this is any better than just the Buffet. So I think that I'm going to be sticking with the Buffet. It is a little bit less expensive. The other nice thing about the Buffet is there aren't any really big contradictions in whether or not you can wear that at a certain time. Now, there is with the one with the copper peptides. You have to wear this one when you're not using niacinamide, you're not using another Buffet, you're not using vitamin C. You have to wear this one separately. So I find that I do use this one in the morning after I do the Alpha Arbutin, the Argireline, and the glycolic acid. I will use this one in the morning, and I'm just really actually trying to get rid of it, to tell you the honest truth, because I'm ready to go back to the regular Buffet. But then the niacinamide, I will switch off days with the copper peptides, because I don't use the niacinamide and the vitamin C at night either. Now, this is where it gets a little bit confusing. I know. All these things can have contradictions in them. And niacinamide has a tendency to kind of nullify or make vitamin C a little bit less potent. And so you really don't want to use niacinamide at the same time you use vitamin C. And I'm not willing to give up my vitamin C, so I'm using the niacinamide in the morning as well with the Argireline and the Alpha Arbutin. So just so you know, Argireline, Alpha Arbutin, I use those both morning and night. Those are the only ones that I can think of right now that I do use in the morning and the night as far as serums go. The niacinamide and the copper peptide Buffet, I am using both of those alternately in the morning. So I don't use a vitamin C in the morning. I just use those two alternately. And then I also use what is called EUK. This is a really strong antioxidant. It stands out differently than most antioxidants, even further than vitamin C as an antioxidant, because this one, you put it on a normal antioxidant, you put it on in the morning, and you want it to protect your face from the pollutants that you are going out into when you step out your door. The UK is one that can kind of self-renew. They found that most antioxidants, you put them on, and a couple hours later, 2-3 hours later, they're no longer protecting you from any free radicals. So this one, the EUK, that has been proven that it's still active. It's still protecting you. It's still giving you that little bit of protection that you need. So I really have loved using this. Now, this is water-free. So you would need to use this one in conjunction with any other oils that you're using or any really heavy creams. You can put it into your morning cream if you want to and use it that way, which is actually what I do. I just put a couple drops in there with my moisturizer, and then I put my moisturizer on. Okay, you guys, we're right before you get into your moisturizer or your oils, and that is the Grenactive Retinoid 5% in squalane oil. What is so great about this product, where it is a retinoid instead of a retinol, is it is a little bit more easy on the skin, and it is a little bit more effective on my skin. I've been using this one on my arms. My arms have really bad spots on them, including my hands, and I've been using this every single day because I want to see a difference. And I kind of am going off of some spots that I have that are super dark, so I can report more back to you later on. But so far so good on this. I think this is my second bottle, and I really am noticing that I'm starting to see some nice skin turnover. My hands, I feel like my hands are the one thing that aged me more than even my face, so I'm really working on my hands right now, and this is helping a lot to do that. Okay guys, I have 8 oils from The Ordinary. I just talked to you guys really recently about the argan oil and the marula oil being dupes for high-end skincare. I also have so many others. I have rosehip seed oil. I have the bee oil. By the way, if you're wanting to try oils and you've never stepped down into it, try the bee oil. It's got a mixture of a bunch of really great oils in there, and they're mixed together, and it's really, really a good oil. Now, I do have a oil video. I'm not going to sit here and tell you guys a lot about my oils because I have a complete dedicated oil video that I will go ahead and link for you guys. Each of these oils has different properties for different things. The oils that I use, I put either in my moisturizer with the EUK in the morning if I want to, and you usually use rosehip seed oil in the morning because it's very brightening and it does have antioxidant benefits in it itself. And at night, I trade off. Okay, so you guys are going, where's the vitamin C, Melissa? Here's the vitamin C, you guys. So ascorbyl tetrasopalmitate, I have no idea if I'm saying that right, solution, 20% in vitamin F. Vitamin F is an essential fatty acid. It is a high vitamin C product. 20% is pretty high. So what they have done with that is they have tried to make it easier on the skin. And that's what I find. Now, I started doing this because I was reading so much about if your retin-A is irritating you, that you can use an oil before it and then put it on. And I thought, well, that's kind of genius because you're diluting it a little bit, but you're also giving your skin a little bit of a barrier, and it just takes longer to sink in, and you're not getting as much irritation. And I was getting a lot of irritation. So I got this because it was in an essential fatty acid. I knew the oil was good for me, but I really wanted to do the vitamin C. Now, what happens with vitamin C and retinol and retin-A? I've been asked this so many times. Aren't you supposed to not use that on the different days? That's not true. That's simply not true. They have proven that vitamin C and vitamin A are super repairers for our skin. So vitamin C actually enhances the effects of vitamin A. They work together. So if you put that vitamin C underneath your retin-A, you're going to have a 1-2 punch, and your skin's going to just look so vibrant and so pretty. And you're going to notice the difference much faster. Now, if you're not one that doesn't like that oily feel from the vitamin F that I use, then go ahead and try another one of their vitamin C's. I have tried a couple of their vitamin C's. I will tell you, I've tried the one in silicone. I do not like that because I can't put moisturizer on after that. I've also tried their 23% that's in a tube. I don't remember what the base is of that. I will throw it up here as we're talking, but I do know that that one, the granules in it were really heavy. The L-ascorbic acid granules, or the powder that they mixed in with it, was really heavy. And I found that if I rubbed that too much, my other skincare was going to pill up, and I was just not going to have very much skincare on my face. I was going to be wiping it away with big old, you know, pills all over my face, and I was going to be, you know, getting it off that way. And I also have tried the powder, the 100% L-ascorbic powder. L-ascorbic powder. That powder is really good, and it comes with this teeny tiny little dropper, and you can put that in any of your moisturizers or any of your oils or anything like that, and it is a super duper strong vitamin C. I was finding that I was getting too much stinging from that, so I kind of backed off from it. At the very end of any of the skincare I'm doing, AM or PM, I will use the natural moisturizing factors. I have loved this. This is so nourishing. So I'm going to read to you all that's in here, and you guys are going to recognize that these ingredients are good ingredients. They've put them together. This is a really good product. So we have multi-amino acids, fatty acids, triglycerides, urea, ceramides, phospholipids, glycerin, saccharides, sodium, PCA, hyaluronic acid, and many other compounds that are naturally present in the skin. You guys, this is a fantastic moisturizer at a superb price point. I mean, come on, how many things on the market can we say have those kind of ingredients and can, you know, be under $10 for something that's going to last you 3 months? So, oh my goodness, this is really, really good. I think that you guys should try it out, see whether or not you like it. Okay, so I didn't show you really any eye products. The Ordinary does not have eye products, but I did tell you that I was going to talk a little bit about the other products. Right now, I am trying the Fractionated Eye Contour Concentrate from NIOD. NIOD is kind of their high-end ones. So we'd have like, I don't know, we'd have like NYX down here, and then way up here would be like Lancome. So that would be where we're comparing these. As far as this one goes, I have been trying it. This is my very first bottle. I started this 2 weeks ago. I've barely touched it because again, you put one drop and you go around your whole eye contour. So I'm excited about this one, and I'll tell you why. This is what its claims are. It says a hyper concentrated bio serum for the eye contour. This combines 28 clinical technologies that target many signs of under eye and above eye aging, polyphenol technology, next generation cyclic peptide technologies, marine science, and modern drone delivery mechanics. I don't know what all that is, but that's what it is. In this single treatment, it is supposed to target aging on the lower and the upper eyelids. It's supposed to target dynamic lines, static lines, fine lines, fine superficial lines under the eyes, loss of elasticity on top of our eyelids, dark circles and puffiness, and textural unevenness with possible visible results in 3 days and very visible results in up to 8 weeks. So I've only been using a couple weeks, but honestly, you guys, I have noticed that I do feel like this area is improving on me. I just feel like it feels and it looks a little bit more plump. Now, as far as my laugh lines out here, I don't feel like it's doing much for those yet, but I think that I'm not going to ever get rid of those because I don't quit laughing. So that's one thing that I'm probably going to have forever. I don't mind about those anyway. So here's your rule of thumb, you guys. First of all, I'm going to list down in the description box when I use what, and I'm going to put AM and I'm going to put PM, and then I'm going to put everything I do in the AM, and then I'm going to put everything I do in the PM. So you guys have a guide as to what I do. It might not work for you, but that's what I do. And my rule of thumb is cleanse. First thing, cleanse, whether it is in the PM or the AM, remove any dirt, remove any oils. I use the cleanser in the PM to remove my makeup, and then I would go in with another cleanser. Like I use the Philosophy as getting, you know, the oils from that off. Now, after that, very thin formulas first. So again, I will use the glycolic acid. I'll use the salicylic acid at night on alternate nights. The next thin formula that I use is the argireline because it's like water. So you're going to want to go in with that one next, and then go in with one of the eye treatments because I like to make sure that I can get all of the eye treatments all the way out, the whole entire contour of the eye. Then go in with your thicker serums. Your thicker serums are your buffets. They're your alpha arbutin, your niacinamide, those kind of things. Go in with those next. So you're going thinnest, very, very thinnest to thickest. That's where we're moving. And I'm not saying that you guys need to use all this because my heavens, I'm a skincare junkie. Lots of people though, they just like, okay, just cleanse, tone, and moisturize. And that's okay. I'm not saying that there's anything wrong with that if that's the way you want to go. I personally just use a little bit more. I love skincare. It's my jam. It's my thing. Right up there with palettes. So you guys know. So after serums, Then comes in my vitamin C if I'm going to use that at night. I put that on and then I put on my retinol on top of that. I let those work together and sink in for quite some time. And then I will go in with my eye cream. As I'm waiting for all of that to sink in, I'll go in with my eye cream. And then I'm going to go in with the natural moisturizing factors. At night, I will put a drop or two of my favorite oil. That's a lot, you guys. I know. It's a hell of a lot. I'm sorry that if this video was way too long for some of you. I knew that it was going to be a long video and I knew that it was going to be very in depth because so many of these have different claims. They do different things. I don't use all of them on certain, you know, one night or another night. They all have their place in my skincare routine. I don't use them all at once. So that is that for sure. But I wanted to make sure that I did this in-depth review for you guys. If you have any questions about any of it, make sure that you ask me in the comment section below. I'm happy to answer any questions. I know this is going to generate a lot of comments and a lot of things, a lot of questions. So bear with me and keep in mind that I will be getting back to all of your questions and all of your comments as soon as I can, because this one is one that everybody wanted to know about, everybody wanted to talk about, and I'm sure we're going to get a lot of discussions going. Get some discussions going with each other. If there's something that somebody asks about and you found that something works really well for you, let them know. It doesn't have to be about Ordinary. It can be about any skincare that you're using. We all want to know about good skincare, right? So, okay. That's everything. Thank you guys so much for watching today and being so patient in this video being so long. I do really appreciate that. Please give the video a thumbs up if you wouldn't mind. That really does help me out a lot. And this is a topic that a lot of people want to know about. So the more thumbs up that we can get, the better off we are into getting it populated out there into YouTube land. So thank you guys once again for everything you do for me, especially for watching today. I hope you're all having a fantastic day and I'll catch you all in my very next video. Take care, you guys. Bye-bye. Bye.